Number 10. Madame Delphine LaLaurie. Madame Marie Delphine LaLaurie was a well-known and captivating socialite who would host lavish parties at her home in the French Quarter of New Orleans, but she hid a disturbing secret, the torturing of slaves for her own sick pleasure. When a young slave girl fell from the roof of her home, authorities fined LaLaurie, made her sell her other slaves, and banned her from taking in any more slaves. Nevertheless, she continued to buy slaves through her family and social connections. She is believed to be responsible for at least 4 known murders. She died in France in either 1842 or 1849, depending on the source. Number 9. William Burke and William Hare. William Burke and William Hare were serial killers living in Scotland who first cashed in when one of Hare's lodgers died suddenly but still owed him rent. Hare decided to sell the body to a private anatomy teacher at the University of Edinburgh who needed cadavers for medical research. The money-hungry duo then planned to kill the lodgers themselves and quickly sell the bodies. They managed to successfully kill and trade the bodies of 16 known victims before their evil scheme came to a halt. They were finally caught when one of the corpses they sold was that of Daft Jamie, who was well recognized by locals. Number 8. Liver-Eating Johnson. Born in 1824 in New Jersey, Jeremiah Johnson is known for the legendary dark stories attached to his name. Johnson served during the Civil War as a logger, trapper, scout, and sheriff. However, he is better known for the 15-year-long war he waged with the Crow Native Americans who killed his wife. According to history books, he scalped more than 300 Crow and cannibalized their livers. Number 7. Jane Taupin. Serial killer Jane Taupin is famously quoted as saying her dream was to have killed more people, helpless people, than any other man or woman who ever lived. Born in 1857, the former nurse from Boston, Massachusetts, used her patients as medical guinea pigs, altering their prescribed dosages and even climbing into bed with them as they lay unconscious. Known as the Angel of Mercy, she finally confessed to 31 murders, although the real victim count is believed to be more like 70 to 100 patients. Number 7. Wild Bill Longley. Wild Bill Longley was known as one of the deadliest gunfighters in the Old West, and he boasted that he had killed 32 men. Born in 1851 in Austin County, Texas, he specifically targeted black men so he could steal their horses. His brutal slayings were overlooked, as the victims were ex-slaves. Number 7. Mary Ann Cotton. English serial killer Mary Ann Cotton is believed to be the mastermind behind the deaths of at least 21 people, including 3 of her 4 husbands and 11 of her 13 children. Cotton's method was a cruel one. She would poison her victims with arsenic and then cash in the insurance policies. Number 7. Jesse Pomeroy. Jesse Pomeroy is the youngest person to ever be found guilty of first-degree murder in the history of Massachusetts. He was 14 at the time. Known as the boy torturer, by the age of 10, he already had a thirst for blood and had begun tearing his mother's songbirds' heads off. On Boxing Day in 1871, 4-year-old William Payne was found hanging from a rope in an outhouse. Then Pomeroy's violent attacks became more frequent. He would slash at other boys with a knife, hold their heads underwater, and scratch at them with his nails. Number 3. The Servant Girl Annihilator. During the years of 1884 and 1885, a serial killer known as the Servant Girl Annihilator terrified the city of Austin, Texas, as he would drag sleeping women from their beds to mutilate and murder them. 8 people, 7 women and 1 man, were killed with an axe, and 6 of the victims were discovered with a sharp object inserted into their ears. The real killer was never captured, and his identity still remains a mystery. 8. Number 2. Amelia Dyer. British serial killer Amelia Dyer was a twisted baby farmer who is believed to have been responsible for the murders of more than 400 babies over 30 years. She advertised in one newspaper, "Married couple with no family would adopt healthy child, nice country home. Terms, £10. In reality, she took the babies from struggling single mothers, strangled them to death or poisoned them with an opiate-laced cordial, and dumped the bodies. Number 1. The Bloody Benders. In the early 1870s, Kansas was home to a family of sinister serial killers known as the Bloody Benders. John and Elvira Bender, alongside their two children, John Jr. and Kate, are believed to have been responsible for the murders of at least 11 known victims. The 5x7-meter, 16x24-feet, wood frame house they lived in sold groceries from the front and doubled as an illegal funeral parlor in the back. When several people went missing from Labette County, the townsfolk called an emergency meeting, and a few days later, the Benders made a run for it.